I always lived in this little town where life is so slow, everything is so slow. Everything was happening so quick, I wasn't used to it.
Did you want to be a professional skateboarder?
In my mind, I wanted to do skateboarding for life, but I didn't know skateboarding could become a job. It never happened before. Actually, I was the first one that became a professional skateboarder.
You're the first Italian to become a professional skateboarder.
Yeah.
What were some of the highlights? Demos, contests, like what are the highlights that you remember?
Even if I wasn't down to do it, the X Games in San Diego, 1998, when I got second, and I couldn't believe Tony got third. No way, is it real? I just beat Tony Hawk. Did it just happen?
Let's hear it for Giorgio Zattoni!
That's a highlight. That doesn't mean I'm better than Tony. I mean, he's Tony.
Do you feel you excelled in contests? Did contests bring something out in you?
No, actually, it was one of the main reasons I quit.
You didn't like competing?
No.
Why?
When I started skating, I was doing contests in Italy, but the contests in Italy were more like a day with friends. There wasn't so much pressure on it. Over there, the level is so high.
It happened too fast and too soon.
Too fast, too soon, and I couldn't handle it.
So you're not a person that likes pressure?
No. There's two kinds of pressure I feel like. But the negative pressure is more when I have to do something because I have to do it. The good pressure is the one that it became from myself, inside of me. I hear rumors that Danny Way was putting up this contest at DC Ramp. He was inviting only a few skaters. That's where we started talking about the Zat flip. I was doing this alley-oop 540 indie grab. The way it looked, it kind of was twisted. People were kind of freaking out because I was the only one doing that thing.
How did you think up this trick? Like, how did it happen?
In this contest, Vance Triple Crown contest, I just pulled it off and I had it like so easy. I could do it pretty much every time I wanted. Still, I dream of California. It's like, I love the place, I love the people, I love like skateboarding there. It's different. That was the greatest experience of my life, for sure, if I think about it. since I had my best moments of my life there, I was missing so much the California life.
What is the California life?
For me, it's skateboarding. You wake up, you are a skateboarder, you live skateboarding, you breathe skateboarding.
It's the spiritual home of skateboarding where it all started.
It's real skateboarding. Here, it's not real. I mean, we do it, but I feel the real thing is over there.
Wait a minute, I have to tell you something. The videos that I've seen of you skating where you live, that's as real as it gets. Tell you, man, I spent a lot of my life looking at skateboarders and watching the best skateboarders, and I could not believe how well you landed that trick. I mean, it was a perfect execution. How did that happen?
Yeah, the 900, I still don't believe I made it. It's magic.
Tony Hawk, when he talked about learning the 540, he said the scary thing about it is you lose sight of the pool for a moment. Well, what's it like when you do a 900?
When you do a 900, you can double that feeling.
How do you keep track of where you're at?
It's the same as I learned the 720 from the 540. I was fakie, rotate 180 degrees, and then I was thinking about the 540. I learned the 720. So I did the same. I did 180 and then I was thinking about the 720. So I kept spinning. So that was, how do you say, mechanism? You have like steps to get there. I could see the landing. The rotation was so fast and my body was spinning too fast to lock the trick down. I knew that if I put it down, I would over-rotate. I was working on it for so long, but at the end, the landing and how it felt, like the trick, was so natural that it felt like landing a regular 540.
Wait a minute, Giorgio, it felt natural to take 6 years to make a trick?
That time, I don't know, it just happened. Love and
happiness. Where are you at with skateboarding today?
I found a way to work and be free for a good amount of time that I can go skate. This is a time where I do it for me. I love it. There's no pressure. It's just fun. So everything is perfect now.
What do you skate now? Primarily ramps?
I skate pretty much pool. We have an Adriatic pool. I'm more into flow skating. I wanna go fast, grind long, go high, and make what I do look easy. this is so beautiful, this is so perfect. When you see it, it's timeless. That is skateboarding.